हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, चैप्टर सरफेस एरियाज एंड वॉल्यूम्स एक्सरसाइज 13.4, इट इज़ ऑफ क्लास 9. आई हैव टेकन क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 13.4. द डायमीटर ऑफ द मून इज अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 1/4 ऑफ द डायमीटर ऑफ द अर्थ. फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ देयर सरफेस एरियाज. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्वेश्चन, द डायमीटर ऑफ द मून इज approximately 1/4 of the diameter of the earth. So suppose this is earth, yes, earth, and diameter is d, diameter is d, yes, and suppose this is moon and its diameter is 1/4. The moon is approximately 1/4 of the diameter of the earth, so its diameter is d upon 4, yes, diameter d, and here the diameter d upon 4 according to the question, yes. So the radius will be d upon 2 of earth, and moon d upon 4 into 2, that is equal to d upon 8. I hope it is clear. This is earth. Of course the shapes are not correct because I have made the earth smaller one and the moon the bigger one, but I just see the difference because of the colors. Yes, this is earth, and the diameter is represented by this d, small d, and according to the question the diameter of the moon is 1/4 of the diameter of the earth, yes, d upon 4. Now we have to find out the ratio of their surface areas. So for the ratio of the surface areas, or for the surface area, we know that the formula is 4 pi r square for the sphere, because both are in the shape of the sphere, yes. Now we need a radius, so the radius will be the half of the diameter, that is d upon 2, and here the because the diameter is d upon 4, because we have taken this from the that is with the earth, because the d upon 4 moon diameter is 1/4 of the diameter of the earth, so that moon is with the radius will be, let represent this with the capital R, and this is of the small r, yes. So the radius is d upon 8, yes. Now ratio of surface area of moon upon surface area of earth, yes, the question wants this. Find the ratio of their surface areas, that will equal to surface area of the moon, that will be 4 pi small r square, because we have taken the radius in the small r, upon 4 pi capital R square, radius of the earth, yes. Now 4 pi will be cancelled out, and this small r is d upon 8, so d upon 8 whole square upon d upon 2 whole square, yes, that is equal to d square upon 8 edge 64 into, that will come in the, we will take the reciprocal and that will come in the numerator, that will be 2 to the 4 upon d square, d square will be cancelled out, 4 1 4, 4 16 is 64, so the ratio is 1:60, yes, clear. So we have to first of all take the diameter of the earth, then we have to, according to the question, we have to proceed that it is given 1/4, and simply we need to put the values in the formula when we have to find out the ratio, and we have got 1:60. Yes, the ratio of the surface area of the moon to the surface area of the earth is 1:16. Now proceed to the next question, that is question number 8. Yes. So of exercise 13.4, class 9, a hemispherical bowl is made of steel 0.25 centimeter thick. The inner radius of the bowl is 5 centimeter. Find the outer curved surface area of the bowl. Yes, as we know that the shape of the let the shape of the bowl is, because it is given hemispherical bowl, so this is the shape, and is made of steel 0.25 centimeters thick. So it means this is the inner radius, this one, this is 0.25 centimeter, yes, and the inner radius of the bowl, that is given 5 centimeter. Find the outer curved surface area of the bowl. So we know that inner radius is 5 centimeter, so, and it is 0.2 centimeter thick, this one is 0.25 centimeter. Find the outer curved surface. So outer radius will be, that is equal to 5 plus 0.25 centimeter. Yes, that will equal to 5.25 centimeter. Okay. Now find the outer curved surface area of the bowl. So outer curved surface area of bowl will equal to, what is the curved surface area of hemisphere? That is 2 pi r square. So 2 into 22 upon 7, the value of pi, and here the r is 5, because we need to find out the outer one, that is the 5 plus 0.25, that will complete, will become 5.25 centimeter to 5.25 into 5.25. Yes, now we have to 7 sevens are 49 and 7 fives are 35. Yes, 0.75. We need to multiply, we need to calculate only. Just after calculating, after multiplying, we have got 2 into 22 into 0.75 into 5.25. That is equal to 173.25 centimeter square. Yes, clear? So we have to just take care of regarding the radius, that is given, this one is given 5 centimeter. After adding this one is 0.25, we can get the outer curved surface area, and we have simply the formula for the curved surface, that is 2 pi r square. We have to put the values and we can get the outer curved surface area. Okay, now come to the question number 9. A right circular cylinder just encloses a sphere of radius r. This is of NCERT question number 9 of exercise 13.4, and this is given. The figure is already actually given. This one is a straight one. Now, a right circular cylinder just encloses a sphere of radius. Thus, radius of the, this is the, that is touching. This is the radius is R. Surface, find the surface area of the sphere. Surface area of the sphere is 4 pi R square. Because already r is given, radius that is given, that is represented by small r. Second one, curved surface area of the cylinder. Now come to the curved surface area of the cylinder. See, the radius of the sphere is equal to the radius of the cylinder also, because it is just encloses sphere is a right circular cylinder is just encloses a sphere. So complete sphere is inside, and that is the radius of the sphere is equal to the radius of the cylinder. So 2 pi आर एच इज द कर्व सर्फेस एरिया ऑफ द सिलेंडर. यस एंड सो वी हैव गॉट द 2πr एंड h इज हियर द हाइट ऑफ द सिलेंडर. नाउ सी द हाइट ऑफ द सिलेंडर. इफ यू सी द डायमीटर ऑफ द रेडियस दैट इज आर दिस वन. When we talk about this sphere, let me explain you with the. This is r. If we take the diameter, this will r. So that will complete is the d diameter. 2r. Yes. If we see from here also, this is also our r. We can see any from anywhere because it is of the circular shape. So that is the 2r is equal to the height of the cylinder. See, this one is the, this is the height of the cylinder, this one, and that is equal to, if we see, r plus r, or we can say 2r, 2pi r into 2r. So even we can say 2 to the 4pi r square. Yes. Now ratio of the areas obtained in first and second. In the first part, we need to find out the surface area of the sphere, this one 4 pi square. Curved surface area of the cylinder, that we have find out 4 pi r square. Because it is the point that you have to see that the height of the cylinder is equal to the diameter of the sphere, and the diameter of the sphere is r plus r. Yes, so that is equal to the 2r, and we have to put the value instead of h, we have to put 2r. And the radius is same for the sphere, and we have got 4 pi square. Now the in the third part, we need to find out the ratio of areas obtained in first and second. And first we have find out the 4 pi square, clearly 4 pi r square. So ratio will be ratio of first and second part, that is the surface area of the sphere upon the curved surface area of the cylinder, that is equal to 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square upon 4 pi r square, that is equal to 1:1. Clearly, that's why I have written with this. Now I have find out surface area of the sphere with the red color, and this curved surface area of the cylinder by a black color, so that you can recognize the difference. And here, see the height, we have put 2r because it is all equal to the diameter of the sphere, and we have to find out the ratio, that is 1:1. Clear? Thank you.